Good evening. It's a very relaxing evening. I don't know what everyone's been doing today, but there's been, obviously, celebrations of Easter at different times, in different places, and it's good just to gather in the evening. And the beauty of the, thanks to the light streaming in. And I also think this is quite a different service because of maybe just the time of day on Easter Sunday, but it also is very special as well because it's just a bit more quiet, it's a bit more restful. And we're going to begin in that, I know it's the evening, but we're going to travel back to the dawn of that first Easter. And we're going to hear the reading from John's Gospel. And Verna and Isabel are going to read that to us, and then we're going to sing a song that reflects that.
So the reading is from John chapter 20. Early on Sunday morning, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been taken away from the entrance. She went running to Simon Peter and the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." Then Peter and the other disciple went to the tomb. The two of them were running, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and saw the linen wrappings, but he did not go in. Behind him came Simon Peter, and he went straight into the tomb. He saw the linen wrappings lying there, and the cloth which had been around Jesus' head. It was not lying with the linen wrappings, but was rolled up by itself. Then the other disciple, who had reached the tomb first, also went in. He saw and believed. They still did not understand the scripture which said that he must rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back home.
But Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white, seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they have put him." At this, she turned round and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus. "Woman," he said, "why are you crying? Who is it you are looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned towards him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet returned to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them I am returning to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." And thanks to God for these readings from his holy word. Amen.
Thanks to Isabel and Verna for that reading from John's Gospel. And one of the first things that the risen Jesus said was to Mary, "Why are you weeping?" And of course, we know something of that background to why Mary was weeping. Jesus, when he was arrested, when he was put on this mockery of a child in the middle of the night, when he was crucified, everything was kind of rushed. His burial was rushed, and therefore the cleaning of the dead body, the anointing of the dead body, still had to be done. And Mary at least wanted to do that. And then, of course, as well as the death of her Rabboni, her Lord, her teacher, her master, there wasn't even the body for her to treat or deal with. And so she went, and Jesus met with her at that point. And this is reflected in our opening hymn, again, as I say to the fact that Easter dawn, I am the Lord of the morning.
Jesus is Lord, may you hear that declare.
rescued her or brought her out from that life? Well, we can only speculate what had happened, what had happened to Mary had affected her and caused hurt and harm, and perhaps the damage that she may also have done, we can only speculate, as I say. But through her relationship with Jesus, she had been transformed and renewed and given purpose and meaning. And then there was that sense of losing it at the time of Jesus' crucifixion. So what was she looking for? Who was she looking for? She was looking for, at that point, a dead body to minister to prepare. And as we know, over the course of that conversation, she was to discover that it was Jesus, her Saviour, her Lord, and she held on to him. And what we're thinking about this morning is that do not claim to me that something of Jesus was the same, the risen Jesus, but something was also different. And I want to read this reflection from Malcolm Gweet in this book, Sounding the Seasons. And it speaks about Easter dawn. He blesses every love that weeps and grieves. And now he blesses hers who stood and wept, and would not be consoled or leave her love's last touching place, but watched as low light crept up from the east. A sound behind her stirs, a scatter of bright birdsong through the air. She turns but cannot focus through her tears, or recognize the gardener standing there. She hardly hears his gentle question, why are you weeping? Or sees the play of light that brightens as she chokes out her reply. They took my love away, my day is night. And then she hears her name. She hears love say, the word that turns her night and ours to day. Beautiful words there from Malcolm Gweet, in that sense that when Jesus addresses her as Mary, it restores and rekindles that special relationship that she has with Jesus. And indeed, Jesus calls each of us by our name, as he is the Good Shepherd and knows us each by name. And when we hear our name called by him, we have that sense of identity, of value, of purpose, and of meaning.
Thank you.
sanctuary and the street prayers by Albert Vogel, Albert Vogel's minister, is a minister of Bonet, and he's also a former moderator of the General Assembly, and he's a very enthusiastic and energetic man, is Albert, and he has also written some beautiful poems here. And we've experienced a beautiful evening today, so I'd like to start with this one. It's called A Perfect Day, not the song by Lou Reed, but a prayer here. Lord, today was glorious, and I just loved the view. The soft sunlight has given us all a rich, warm glow. Your world is quite spectacular. The colour scheme is breathtaking. When the sun shines, it seems to bring out the best in everyone. People actually talk to each other. The TVs get turned off, and people go for walks. Lord, I just love the view looking over our town. It calls from within me a prayer I heard from a friend recently. So simple, yet so profound. Come down and come in. So Lord, I pray, come down and come into our town, our homes, our shops, our schools, our churches, and above all, come down and come into our hearts. Lord, could we be like the tree that has been planted by the river, flowing through our community, bringing health and healing to our families? Lord, come down, come in, your kingdom come. A beautiful prayer that we can use many different times, come down and come in. And this next prayer is more specifically towards the Easter morning. And this one is called, this prayer, sorry, is called, Can I Stay in the Garden? Lord, I want to be a stone that can move, but I don't want to be always rolling. I don't want to be immovable. I just want to be known as this stone, this spirit moved. I want to be seen as a living stone, no longer a blocker, but a witness to a resurrection. Roll me away from the grave, but keep me always in the resurrection garden, so that I can encounter doubt and healing, tears and laughter, despair and hope, and above all, that I can perhaps meet angels and disciples talking with the gardener. And the lovely prayers they conjure pictures that are very apt. And as anyone who knows me, I'm more a Rolling Stones fan than a Beatles fan, and the next prayer here is called Stone Rolling God, but I don't think it's referring to the rock group, the Rolling Stones, but here it is. Stone Rolling God, you surprise us all again. Each act of grace surprises the last. You roll a stone and reveal a mystery. You roll a stone and the dead come to life. You roll a stone and angels speak to humans. You are such a generous God. Your acts of grace are inspirational. Your talk of forgiveness is breathtaking. Your acts of forgiveness are life-changing. Your love stretches beyond the boundaries of reason. You are a most unreasonable God. You turn logic on its head. You celebrate the weak smite the elderly. You revive the young. You roll a stone, and the world is changed for eternity, all in the roll of a stone. What a roll! What a stone! What a God! So I hope you enjoyed those prayers by Albert Bovell. Let's come to God in prayer. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you for this evening hour, this time to continue to celebrate the amazing love made known, the amazing life made known after death through your Son Jesus, and the hope eternal that brings, and how the resurrection brings change and healing in so many different situations that can seem to be a brick wall. Loving God, help us to continue in a spirit of Easter celebration in the coming week and months ahead. And we thank you for people we love and have heard of this evening, and we remember especially Sissy and Barbara and others who are unable to be with us this evening. We pray that they would have that sense of being supported in love and prayer in the fellowship, the body of Christ. Lord God, we pray for your church at a time of change and challenge, that we would be faithful to Jesus calling upon us, the calling of each of us by name, and to follow his leading into the new heaven, into the new earth, into the kingdom come down among us. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Right, we're going to go out with joy, but in both hymns. This is the day that the Lord has made.
This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made. We will rejoice, we will rejoice, that he added it, that he added it. This is the day that the Lord has made, we will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
Let us indeed go out with joy and praise and thanksgiving for the presence of the risen Lord. And may we be mindful of those we encounter, those we meet, to reflect something of the Easter hope contained in our hearts. And the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with us now and evermore. Amen.